Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. And if you're part of our Telegram group, you've probably seen the same frustration that comes up frequently. When you're building apps with AI tool, it feels like you ask the model to build your house and it's quite impressive. But the moment you ask it to paint it red, suddenly all the windows are gone, right? Adding new features often break old ones, and that back and forth can really be exhausting. So when I came across this new tool that solves this problem, I knew I had to share it with my community. It's called TestSprite, like the MCP, right? And honestly, it's a total game changer. For anyone building with AI assistant tools like Cursor, Copilot, or any modern coding assistant, now we've all used AI to speed up development, but it could also have bugs and broken integration. What makes TestSprite special is that it doesn't just tell you what's wrong, it automatically detects and even helps you fix those issues. It's like the entire QA engineer, right, built right into your workflow. And here's what really sets it apart. It actually tests your GUI and integrates checks. The best part, it's fully automatic. You know, writing of test code, no detailed prompts, just install it, connect it, and watch it go to magic. And that's why it's been trained all over the dev community. It was recently featured as number one on Product Hunt. Developers everywhere are loving it. And in today's video, I'll walk you through exactly how to set up TestSprite MCP to automatically test, debug, and even polish your code. Whether it's an existing project or a brand new project, this will work for you. So stay with me, let's dive in.
The first thing, right, getting started is really super easy. You need three things. You need a compatible IDE, right? If you're using Cursor, if you're using GitHub Copilot, or even, you know, other tools that support MCP integrations. You need a TestSprite account. You can sign up for free. You can see here, if you come to the page, you tell you can sign up for free. And please, you can also use the link I'll leave in the description, right? And you get your 1 month free trial. The third thing you need is your API key, which connects TestSprite to your IDE. So you will find the official links in the description below. Those are my affiliate links, which means if you use them, you're directly supporting this channel at no extra cost to you. Yes, thanks in advance for helping me make these videos. So if you click on try for free. Okay, so once the setup is done, you just need to click on got it, and you can test your MCP locally, right? So yeah, you can see the instruction on how to do it. I have Cursor. So first thing, I need to create an API key. Right? So I'll create a new API key, and we'll name for our project. It's called Oya One More. So we'll name it Oya One More, right? And create. And then you can copy the key. Do not worry. I'll be deleting this key even before the video goes live. So once we've copied, and we now have the key, you can come back here, just switch back to the second tab to see. So yeah, I have, even though I have Claude Code, I also have Cursor, so I'll just be using Cursor to show the example, right? So I'm going to just click add to Cursor, and this should, redirect to Cursor, right? So it needs me to put my API key that I just copied. So I'll paste that here. And I will click on install. See, and we now have 6 tools enabled, and you can see all the different tools that can be used. Let's move on to the project, right? You can see I have a project open here already. It's a corporate website. It's an existing project, and to get the most out of TestSprite, you can provide a product requirement documentation. You can either write one yourself or let TestSprite infer and generate one automatically from your code base. Personally, I prefer creating one quickly within Cursor. I would just select a reasoning model, right? That's the models that have this reasoning icon. I could just select a reasoning model and prompt it to analyze the project structure, right? I want to generate a PRD. Go to the project and generate a PRD document in .md format for me, right? Alternatively, you can actually copy the information about your project. You must have something you used in building it, so like a minor documentation, or even go to ChatGPT and just tell it about the project, you know, what and what has been done, what you want to do, and ChatGPT can actually help you generate a PRD documentation. And now the generation is done, we can see the summary of what it was able to get out, right, about the project. And let's just review the PRD that was created, and we can see we now have a, you know, a very detailed PRD. Now, when you have your PRD, either from ChatGPT or even from Cursor, you can just keep it on the project. And the next thing you need to do, right, is ask Cursor to test the project for you with TestSprite. So I've just started a brand new chat and say, you know, help me test this product with TestSprite. Tell it to test the product for you with TestSprite. And since it's already connected as a MCP, it should know what to do. So usually when ChatGPT is done running it and it calls the test tool, it will have a pop-up and you can choose what you want to test. So for me, I'll be saying the front end, and I'll be saying I want the entire code base, right? And if there's a login username and password, you can put that. The port is going to be running on, right? The project, you can put that. I think for me, this is fine. Also, you need to upload the specification, right? And so I will just, you know, select the PRD, open it, and I'll click on continue. It's actually as easy as that. So once it says okay, the window closes, the code will continue to run. And so we can actually see it work, right? The test starts to running, and we can see the progress from here. We can go to test Sprite dashboard to see the reports. So once it's actually done, you can open test Sprite to see the results, right? The dashboard. I will go to home. Right, and we can see the last test that was done. Okay, so let's look at a test that passed, right? We can, if we open this, we can actually see the recording of the test when the test was done. So this test is to test the team awareness for notification. You can see it was able to navigate there and was able to change the team, right? And even fill the form and whatnot. And you can see the code it wrote to, you know, power this particular test. So this is just one of the very unique features. It's like, it's where it's different from, you know, unit testing. So even if something fails, you can actually see what exactly is failing and how it's failing. So for this one now, it's okay, toggle dark mode toggle functionality, right? So we can open this one and we'll be able to see, you know, more about the errors, how it failed and why it failed, right? Error empty response. Okay, there's some stuff it was unable to load and whatnot. So you will see a summary of how many tests passed, how many tests failed, and even, you know, detailed explanations why they fail, right? For example, you see this one, it failed the email validation sign up. Okay, validation is inconsistent and incomplete. It allows submission of invalid emails and blocks others without consistent behavior. Critical error. So you can see that there's a summary of the stuff that are wrong with the code. You can see even the, you know, the code, right? And even if we look at the passing test cases, you also still be able to see a video of the test case and why they passed. So this is something that makes it different from even the traditional testing, right? You can see it's way totally different from what we see in the traditional testing. Now that we know what failed, let's fix it, right? Back in Cursor, let's just go back to Cursor. Back in Cursor, I would open the file that test sprite has flagged and apply its suggested fix. So I would just say, you know what, and once I apply those fixes, I'll say help me run the test again. It's as simple as that. So me, I would just be, instead of opening it one by one, you see it can tell you the actions and what to do. I would say help me fix this, right? Or even if you manually fix this, all you have to just do is say help me run the test again. And obviously, so you know, let's just try the practical. Help me fix this. So you can see Cursor creates a to-do list of most of the critical issues that were wrong and starts to work on them. So once it's done fixing it, I will now tell it to, you know, help me test, right? Test it again with TestSprite. And once you actually help you test again, you can see it's trying to rerun the test, right? And this time we'll have more tests that is going to pass.
So that's how I use Cursor, ChatGPT, TestSprite MCP, right, together to automatically build and test a full web app. Let's quickly recap what makes TestSprite MCP stand out. It automatically creates, manages, and even validates your PRD. It generates, runs, and refines your test without any coding. It's able to detect, help, and fix both logic and UI bugs. It improves the reliability of your application from 40% to like 90%. It's fully no code, no prompt, right? And it's already topping the charts. It was, like I said earlier, it was number one on Product Hunt and quickly becoming every developer's favorite assistant. If you'd like to give it a try, I've dropped a link on the description below. You can create your free account and start testing your own project right away. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, don't forget to like and subscribe. Drop a comment because it really encourages me. And let me know what project you would like to see next. Thank you.